Hi, this is Jesse Michaels from Operation Ivy and Classics of Love, and you're listening to the Manno Brothers on Q101, and they're really nice guys, really.
But you'll never get out, my.
But it's great. Thank you very much for coming in.
Oh, thanks for having us.
Mike Park, been a fan of yours for a long time, everything you've done, and Jesse Michaels, obviously, from Operation Ivy and Common Rider, Big Rig, yeah, very cool.
I was in a really crappy band in high school, and the only thing we'd do is play Operation Ivy songs.
What songs
did
you do?
I was too.
That's a good answer. No, but seriously, it's a treat to have you guys in here.
Yeah, thank you so much. It's great to be here.
Yeah.
We were just talking a bit off the air, but Classics of Love, how long has this project been rolling?
About 6 months now.
Okay, why? I know Classics of Love was the name of a Common Rider song.
Uh-huh. Well, we were having, it's always a struggle to find a band name, and Max suggested it, and one of the things you have to deal with is finding something that's not likely to be trademarked by someone else, and it actually costs a couple $1,000 to do a thorough search. You have to get...
Are you serious?
Yeah, because you really have to get people to dig deep. You can't just Google it.
Right, right.
That helps. But anyway, so we figured that was pretty safe, because I had used that before. And we liked it. Our music is darker than stuff I've done in the past in some ways. So we thought it was a nice contrast between Classics of Love, which sounds sort of light, and the slightly darker music.
How'd that show go, though, at Reggie's?
Reggie's was good. I liked it. Actually, it was a fun show. I thought we played really crappy the night before in Minneapolis, so, and I thought we hit it very, very well in Chicago, so that was a fun show. And just seeing a lot of friends, it seems like a lot of people think Asian Man Records, which is the label I run, is from Chicago, because we have so many Chicago bands, but through the years, making so many friends and getting to see them in Chicago.
Growing up, listening to your music and seeing all of the bands, all of our friends have been inspired by you, they're in bands, and to be like sort of their, you know, the roots of it, and to walk, you know, down a hall like this and have, I don't know, maybe one out of however many people recognize you. Is that different?
Well, that was largely intentional, because after Op Ivy broke up and I started seeing it getting big, I didn't really want to be in the limelight because everybody has the thing they want in life. Mine just doesn't happen to be fame.
Sure.
I look at it, you know, what people call celebrity or fame, insofar as I have it. I don't really believe in it, but insofar as that exists, I look at it as a tool to get the music out there.
Is the EP out now? Yours? Is it?
It's not out in stores. The street date is June 23rd.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We have it for the shows on tour.
Okay.
But it won't be in stores until June 23rd.
And where can people go to find out more about Classics of Love and Mr. Mike Park?
Well, right now they only have a MySpace. It's just myspace.com, Classics of Love Band. But you could find out some information about them at AsianManRecords.com and pre-ordering information. We'll do some limited edition vinyl colors for the release, so just check that out if you're interested, if you're a vinyl collector.
People give up and just kind of they move on with their lives and just kind of turn their back on what they were passionate about at one point. And you two are both very good examples of people.
Very inspiring.
I mean, that have never done that, and that is awesome. I applaud that very hard. My hands would bleed.
Thank you.
Thanks. But you know, peers that we grew up with from high school, I kind of understand that. The reason they got out of music, it's not practical.
It's pretty much a life destroyer. It's more like an addiction than anything else. But actually, I say that in a tongue-in-cheek way.
Sure.
I just really love it, and that's why I do it. If I was like making a really pragmatic life plan, you know, going on tour and playing small places to 100, 200 people would not be like number one on the list. But it's such a great time. It makes it all worth it. It really is fun for me.
Well, thank you guys, all of you, very much for coming in.
Making a little time for us.
Right on. Well, thanks for having us.
Thank you so much.
We appreciate it.